On this week's Xamarin Essential API of the Week, we take a look at version tracking, enabling you to track the version of your application that's installed in your user's device with a single line of code. So tune in. Welcome back, everyone, to another Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Today, we're going to take a look at version tracking, which is a super cool API to enable you to track the versions of the application that your user has used and installed into their device. Now, what's great about this is that it's much more than just the version and build information. There's helper methods and properties to understand how your users are upgrading your application and to detect what version they're on and if it's even the first time they've launched that version. You can not only see the current version, previous version, but all the versions that the user has added into the application. So let's take a look to see how easy it is to integrate into your application. So here I am on docs.microsoft.com, and of course we have our great getting started guides, and you'll find information about every single API in Xamarin Essentials. So here's version tracking. So here we'll go ahead and make sure we have the Essentials NuGet package installed, and we can read about every single property that is available and exactly how it's stored onto our iOS or Android or Windows device. So let's go into the application and set it up. I, of course, have installed Xamarin Essentials in all of my applications and my shared .NET standard code. So now the next thing that we'll want to do is ensure that we've set up our Android application correctly. There's a little bit of setup code here to initialize Xamarin Essentials and to request permissions. Now for tracking versions, you don't need any additional permissions, but best practice is to add that here. So here's my version tracking page. It has a few labels to see the current version, past version, and display something if it's a new version of the app that I've been using. So the version information is stored inside the Android manifest on Android. So here we can see that it is 1.0 is the version name displayed to the user, and the version code or build ID is 1, and that's an integer that needs to be incremented. For iOS, that's stored in the info p list. The version here is 1.0 and build is 1. Now on iOS, it's a little bit different. The build identifier doesn't need to be an integer like Android, but a lot of developers like to synchronize those version numbers together, and that's what I like to do. So when I want to get access to it, we're going to need to first start tracking the version code. So what I'm going to do is come into my app.xaml or whatever your application launches. So the main activity, if you're doing Android, the app.xaml for Windows, or the app delegate for iOS. But since we're in a Xamarin Forms app, we can come and initialize it. So we'll say xamarin.essentials.versiontracking.track. That's going to initialize the tracking versions. So every time the app starts, it will save the brand new version code for the app. Now in our code behind here, whenever our version page loads up, we can go ahead and output some information. So for like current, for instance, we can say text, and we'll go ahead and output some information here. And we'll say version tracking dot, and we'll get the current build. And then what we can do is maybe put in some information about the current version that's user visible. So there's current version. And then what we'll do is we'll do the same, but we'll do it for the previous. So here, instead of label current, we'll say label past. And instead of the current build, we'll say previous build and the previous version. There we go. Cool. So now when we launch this application, we'll go ahead and see that we should get version code 1 and version name 1.0. Now this is the very first time that I'm ever tracking anything in this application because I just added the tracking code and installing it for the very first time. So what we should see is nothing for the previous version. So let's go ahead and let it deploy over here onto my Android device. There we go. Now I'll go into the version tracking, and there we go. We see that we have 1 and 1.0 and nothing. Now if I come back in and I add some breakpoints here and go in and out of this page, so let's go in and out of it here, there we go. We can see we have all the different version tracking information here, so I can look at all if it's the first time it's being launched, or the version history, which is a set of strings, and a lot more. But like I said, you could track some additional information. So here, maybe I want to go ahead now and say if version tracking dot is the first launch. So notice here that we can say it's the first launch for the current build, for the current version, or you can even say this is the launch for a specific build or version code. So that's nice when you want to update your user about a specific feature. So we'll say, hey, you know, is there a new version? We'll say label new.text equals new version. There we go. This is going to return a Boolean for us there. So now what we can do is come back and we'll say version 1.1 and build 2. We'll go ahead and recompile up our application. And we'll go ahead and add some breakpoints here again. So we'll see the new current build and previous build and additional information for this application. Now this will take a few more seconds since I'm changing the Android manifest file because it has to recompile a new full APK for us. But we'll go ahead and let it launch here in a few seconds. There we go, deploying. And now we're starting our debug process. There we go. Now when I go into that version tracking, we'll go ahead and see now that we have a brand new version previous of 1 and current of 2. If I go into my version tracking and zoom in here, we can go ahead and see that I have now two versions in my history that are there, and I can even look at the build history of when my users were using it. And now we'll see that this is a new version because it is the first launch for the current build. If I was to come in and relaunch this application one more time, it's no longer the first launch for the current build. Remember that, that's what I'm looking for. So when I come in and relaunch this application again, and you look at the version tracking, we no longer see it's a new version. It's the current version, and the user's already used it once. So there you have it. With just a few lines of code, we've enabled version tracking into our application. And additionally, we've checked to see if it's the first launch, bumped it, and done all the fancy schmancy things to see the current and previous builds with Xamarin Essentials. Hope that you enjoyed this Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Make sure you subscribe wherever you're watching right now to get notified about all the great Xamarin content. This has been another Xamarin Essential API of the Week, and thanks for watching. Hey, it's James. I'm just checking in and wanted to thank you for watching this awesome Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Now, don't forget to do all the things, such as like, subscribe, and ding that notification bell for even more videos. And while you're here, check out more Xamarin Essential API videos of the week. They're all right here. Go do it right now. It's awesome.